Hi guys, welcome to a new video of Pastel's Freebie. So today I'm going to be giving you a tutorial on how to draw Ron Weasley. This is part of my Harry Potter series. So here is my planner sketch for Ron Weasley. So we have his head, he's wearing a robe, and he's holding a wand, and he has a peace sign, of course, and he has his bangs, which you want to make sure that you draw his bangs. So let's start. So we're just going to make a sketch of his body. So this is his head. Just do like a bunch of circles, try to get the right shape for his head, and then his little neck is just two curves, and his shoulder. So his right shoulder goes down, and then he's holding the wand, so it's kind of like overflowed. His sleeve is overflowed, and the other shoulder he's holding a peace sign, so it angles upwards. So now we're going to just do the sketch of his hair. So his hair, it kind of parts. So we're just gonna, this is a very, very rough sketch, and we have his ears, and his hair also continues under his ears. So now we're gonna start doing the actual drawing of him. So let's start with his head. His head is basically a U shape. Even though I told you to draw a circle, you wanna kind of trace under the under part of the circle and the sides to make a U shape. So just try to make a U shape that is symmetrical, and it will take a few tries, because as you can see, I keep erasing it. So anyways, let's look at my plan/sketch. So you can see his bangs, they're pretty messy, no offense. So just do a bunch of triangles or lines, or just lines going down, lines going horizontal, lines going diagonal, it doesn't really matter. So now we're just going to do a dot, and like right above the center of his head, and then part it. So just do like two kind of humps from each side of the dot and make it go down. Kind of make it go down right where the bangs are, and then right when you're continuing to draw your hair, going down, curve it into the head, and then draw your ears under, and then draw the hair under the ears. So that's all for the hair. I know that was a lot. You can pause if you want. So for the neck, just do two curves and one curve underneath to finish it all. So now we're gonna start on his shoulder. So of course he has two shoulders, so you're just gonna wanna make two curves that go down. So for one of the curves, for his left curve, for his left shoulder, make it go down and then make it stop like midway and then curve it up, because that's going to be his arm. And then kind of just do the same thing, make it parallel, just like curve it back in. And then for his right one, just make his shoulder or his sleeve kind of a little fat or a little thick, because it's going to be overflowing because his sleeve is bigger than his arm. And then you just want to bring it back up. And for the right hand, bring it back down. So the opposite for each hand. So bring it down for right and bring it up for left. So if you look at his right arm, his sleeve kind of goes out. So I just made it go out like towards the bottom. So that was better. So now we're just going to do the inside of his robe. So he's also wearing a sweater. He's wearing three layers, his robe, his sweater, and then like just a suit. Just like a plain white shirt. So just do like a V shape to show where the robe kind of parts out. So you want to make sure that it's reasonable, because the robe is gonna kind of, I don't know how to explain, it's gonna start from the V shape and go down. So his shirt, there's kind of like two flaps, so just basically just do a backwards or upside down V into his tie, which is basically a V inside of his, the two flaps. It's basically like a circle or like an oval or V, like I said. And then just do two lines coming down, and I just shaded it to show where I'm gonna color it, but you don't have to. So just kind of make the V, or you can fix the V accordingly. Make sure it's a reasonable place. And your robe, it's not gonna connect at all. It's gonna connect by, it's not gonna touch at all. It's gonna be connected by two kind of, how to, like, you know how when you tie shoes, and you know how you use laces, and yeah, you know what I mean. It's going to be connected by like two strings. I don't know how to explain it. Two strings, I guess. So your robe is going to fan out from each side. So I just made them curve down, and I'm going to do a line at where the shirt would end. So back to the two strings. So I just did four rectangles in total, two rectangles on each on this very side of each part of the robe, and I connected it with a string in the middle. So now you know what I talk about when I'm talking about shoelaces, right? Okay, So you're done with the rope. So now we're gonna work on his badge. So his badge is literally just like a home plate shape, so kind of like a pentagon upside down. And then he has like a phoenix and the wings. I think it's a phoenix. Outline around the home plate shape. So I just did like some weird curves around the home plate shape, and inside the pentagon, upside down pentagon, you want to divide into four sections. So after I was done fixing this sleeve, I just did the pants. So the pants, literally just pants, they're just do like two half rectangles under the robe, and kind of make a both of the rectangles. You want to draw a line above and then make it connect at the top. So make sure that it's a reasonable height. So where would the pants actually end? How long would the legs actually be, and how thick would the legs be? And I added a little belt. So now for the feet, I just did two rectangles with a curve at the bottom for its feet, and then I did socks. So the shoes is just curve and then a line down and then a curve at the bottom. And for the shoelaces, I just did like a heart shaped butterfly thing. So for the peace sign on his left hand, it's a thumb, which is a curve, and then two fingers coming out of the thumb. So you can make sure that the finger goes into the thumb, although when you actually do a peace sign, it doesn't go into the actual thumb. But for this cartoon, we're going to make it go into the thumb. Make the other finger kind of stop on the thumb, and then next, and then under the thumb, and the pinky is just next to the thumb. So now we're going to do his other hand. So this is really hard. Just think of a bunch of rectangles. So just do like little rectangles next to each other, and do like a finger that's holding the wand. The wand is literally just a long, skinny rectangle. And I also did a finger behind the wand to kind of show how it's holding it. So you can just adjust this to how it looks like it's holding a wand to you, because this part was like the hardest part for me. So anyways, this is just a close-up of the hand that I did not draw that well. And that's the close-up of the peace sign. So now we're going to work on his face. So do just two kind of big ovals and try to make them as close to each other as possible. Not that close though, because that's really creepy. Do two pupils and do a star. So you can do any star. So you can just like include the lines in the star. You can just make like stars the complicated way. I made it the complicated way. So anyways, just shade in the rest of the space and do the eyebrows and the smile, and I did like some freckles around it, and that's basically it for his face. And so since I'm done, I'm gonna Sharpie it and now color it.
I've seen you in a movie, I heard you in a song. Now I know that this will never go wrong. Like you already knew me, that's why we get along. Yeah, I know that this will never go. Ooh, it's cinematic in the way we connected. Girl, you're so familiar, I never expected you to be right in my arms. You're my favorite part, how you talk in the dark. Oh God, there's something about the sound of you is stuck in my head. I'm hopelessly romanticizing all that you said. Onto the floor, feels like I felt this feeling before. I've seen you in a movie, I heard you in a song. Now I know that this will never go wrong. Like you already knew me, that's why we get along. Yeah, I know that this will never go wrong.
Okay, so after I finished coloring Ron, this is the background I did. So thank you for watching this video. Thanks for watching, and see you later. Bye.